Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Gurur Devo Maheshwara, Guru Sakshat Param Brahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha, Satchidananda Rupaya, Vishwotpatyadi Hetave, Tapatraya Vinashaya, Shri Krishnaya Vayam Numaha, Shri Krishnaya Vayam Numaha. Om Yonda Pravishya Mama Vacha Mimam Prasuttam Sanjeevayatya Akhila Shakti Dharaswadhamnam Anyasha Hasta Charana Shravanatvagadi Pranan Namo Bhagavate Purushaya Tubhyam Pranan Namo Bhagavate Purushaya Tubhyam Pranan Namo Bhagavate Purushaya Tubhyam. We are in Bhagavatam, Canto 16, no, 15, Canto 11, Chapter 16. And here we are looking at the glorious manifestations of the Lord. And last week we saw these first five verses. And there the question that Uddhavji asks is, Yeshu Yeshu cha bhaveshu bhaktya tvam paramarshayaha Upasina prapadyante sansiddhim tad vadasvame. In the third, please point out to me those particular yeshu yeshu cha bhaveshu. Please point out to me those particular entities by contemplating on you through which, with devotion, men of supreme wisdom are able to attain the highest realization or highest perfection or highest merging, and to which are able to attain highest perfection in the form of true devotion or saving wisdom. So what are those special manifestations, and why is this question being asked? Because this is Bhagavat Mahapuran. Here it is Uddhavji has already come to this conclusion. What? That Bhagwan is essentially formless and attributeless, and therefore even though he is infinitely available outside and fully pervading him from inside, yet he is not able to catch him. That is his issue. So we are seeing everything, but our attention goes to the objects, isn't it? And people, our attention doesn't go to the Lord. Our attention doesn't go to the substratum. Our attention doesn't go to the essence of everything that is around us or inside us. So he has understood that, and he's asking this question in the next verse. Gudascharasi bhutatma bhutanam bhuta bhavanaha natvam pashyanti bhutani pashyantam mohitani te natvam pashyanti bhutani. I'm not able to catch you in the outside world, O Lord. Even though you are plentifully available, I am not able to catch you. So where do we get lost?
Names and forms.
Names and forms. We know water only as ocean, as tsunami, as wave, as a drop, as a lake, as a well, as a pond, as a rain. But we don't know water as water. We always use the water whenever in its utility value. Because by itself, we hardly think of it. We only think of, hey, give me a glass of water. Do you say, give me water? A glass of water. Same way, gold. What do we do with gold? We know gold as different ornaments. Similarly, See, there you know, even if you know it is water, you know you are using all these names, but you are not, your attention can be on water or cannot be on water. You are using gold, you know the value of gold, therefore you are investing in gold. Plus beautifying yourself. So when we are moving around in this world, just like you give value to the gold, are you giving value to the essence of this world? Uddhavji Maharaj is saying here that the inner control of beings, you remain hidden from our view. Even though you are plentifully available, you are hidden from our view. Therefore, O life giver of all created beings, deluded by you, living beings are unable to perceive you. So this delusion is not self-created. This delusion, this illusion, because of which? Because of delusion, illusion has come. Because of non-apprehension, misapprehension has come. Because of ignorance, projection has begun. This ignorance that I am finding myself in, this delusion that my mind is clouded with, this is also yours, not mine. Don't take ownership of any damn thing. So who's deluding your mind? Huh? God, as what?
Maya.
As Maya. See? So don't take responsibility. But we are used to taking responsibility. So he says, you have only deluded my mind, and deluded by you, living beings are unable to perceive you because of this delusion which you have created on our minds. We are unable to catch you even though you are plentifully available, O Lord. And therefore, even though you behold them all, still we are unable to catch you. Before us, before I was born, you were. While I am living, you are. After this body dies, still I will be. You are inside me, you are outside me, you are inside everyone, outside everyone. There is no place that you are not. Yet, O Lord, I am unable to perceive you. See? So, let's move away a little bit from this. Why are we not perceiving Lord, even though he is plentifully available? Let's do some brainstorming session before we listen to Lord's answer. Why are we not perceiving him? Tell quickly, one by one, everyone.
Ignorance.
Ignorance, okay.
Priority on the world.
Priority on the world.
Giving more importance to the other thing than
the Lord. Than the Lord, very good.
Individuality.
Huh?
Individuality,
okay. Kuti.
We
forget our true nature. What? Blank? What's his name again?
Uden.
No, why are we not perceiving him? Why are not we experiencing Lord? Even though he's plentifully. Next, Amma. We think he is somewhere else. Remember, this answer is not an intellectual question. You listen to your heart. Find out where, why you are not experiencing him right now and come up with the answer. Don't, what you have heard, what did Swamiji say or what did the Bhagavad Gita say, don't worry about all that. This is your opportunity to find out what is stopping you from experiencing him right here and now. Ajay? Because you don't know yourself. Okay.
Because he is the subtlest of the subtle, we can't comprehend him.
Your mind cannot comprehend him. Okay. Arvind?
So mind always thinks about the world,
not about the Lord.
Attached to the family.
Attached to the family, big one.
Mo
Maya. But Naam Prashila. और मोह माया में फंसी है. प्रशिला मीन्स पता है क्या? सॉलिड फाउंडेशन. हाँ, नॉट इनफ लव फॉर हिम, दैट्स अ बिगी. वी हैव लॉट ऑफ लव फॉर द वर्ल्ड बट वी डोंट हैव इनफ लव फॉर द लॉर्ड. बीइंग मटेरियलिस्टिक, लैक ऑफ कंसिस्टेंट एफर्ट टू फॉरगेट हिम, दैट ऑल्सो वी आर कंसिस्टेंटली ट्राइंग टू फॉरगेट हिम बाय गेटिंग इन्वॉल्व इन द वर्ल्ड. Passively speaking, it is that only, to find him. Okay, Anup?
We just know God as a form.
We know God as a form, but do you go see that form, experience that form all the time? So that's my question. Okay, what's his name? Kutti. Nahin, Vinay. Mental diarrhea. Ah. Come, I'll give you Aesop goal. This is the Aesop goal. Clear up. Ah. Suni, loudly. Carelessness. In other words, laziness. Procrastination. Abhi toh bahut time, I am very young yet. She's talking about herself. Ah, next. Lack of awareness. Amma, Sajita, I hate it. मैं छोड़ूंगा नहीं फिर आके बाद में. हाँ, tell, go in, find out what is that.
Prarabdha.
Prarabdha. Amma at the back. Lack of devotion. Okay. Now I can say all of the above. So here he says, Ya kascha bhumau divi mairasayam vibhutayo dikshu maha vibhute tamayam akhyayanubha vitaste namamite tirtha padangri padmam. Mention to me all those powerful manifestation of yours. O Lord, invested by you with your own divine glory. You have to be... Okay, let me finish this, what it means, and then I'll explain. That may be existing on earth, in the quarters, in the heaven, or in the subterranean region, O Lord of infinite prowess, I bow to your lotus feet, which are the abode of all sanctuaries. So when he says here that, mention to me all those powerful manifestation of yours, invested by you with your own divine glory. Which are the special manifestations? True, I'm breaking the mindset here. Are you not the most unique person in this planet? Are you not the most unique person? Is there anyone like you, like you, like you? All are special, isn't it? Did you bring the life in this body by yourself? So, I'm trying to take your mind away from the Dasha Avatar, and then we'll come back to it. First, understand this, that everything is in this creation is unique. No two mosquitoes are similar. No two amoeba are similar. No two cells are similar. No two organs are similar. No two limbs are similar. No two, if you just take the, what do you call these?
Fingerprints.
No two people will have the same fingerprints. How many? 7.5 billion people. How can that be? Everyone is unique, and every one of us, every creature on this planet, in this creation, the life has been presented in that particular form by the Lord Himself. He alone is manifesting through that, isn't it? So are we not all special manifestations in that sense?
Yes.
In the larger sense. Now, that's a different question, that we are deluded, so we are not recognizing. Therefore, we need special manifestations to focus our mind. Right? But see the Sanatan Dharma. What does it say? That you see the special manifestation in your husband. How? Pati Dev. Consider husband to be the God. The man sees the goddess in his wife, not as a commodity to be owned. You understand? When you see the children, you don't see my children, you see them as a gift of Lord and nurture them that way. This was the right way. It's corrupted, that's a different matter. Understand? That was the way of a Sanatan Dharma, which has been systematically diluted in our country at this moment. Hopefully it will come back again with Modi's rule or revival of the Sanatan Dharmi. People have to believe that our culture is the greatest, great. Then it will happen. So that is one side of it, that we are all specific, special manifestations of the divine. Within us also, now think, is everyone same or some are special? So all are same, everyone has the same body. But within us also, someone has more power, physical power, someone has less physical power, so he looks up to the more, he doesn't mess around with that fellow, isn't it? Someone has more intellectual power, someone has less intellectual power, so he goes and takes support of that. Someone is expert in accountancy and you go for your tax to him. Someone is expert in IT and they don't do their job, yet you go to them. Someone is good at cooking, you go to them, that, oh, you know, so that is my, in which house best dosa, in which house best pongal, in which house best roti, in which house this sabji is best, in which house, so accordingly I plan my monthly tour. special manifestation, you see. So everyone is special and you do go. Now it doesn't end with the caliber in each human being. Some human beings in this creation have gone past the normal level of excellence. Scientists in the modern times, in the olden times, rishis, munis. Patanjali was a rishi. Gave the Yoga Sutras. Valmiki was a lower than a normal man, but he excelled, came over his drawbacks and shortcomings, and was able to bring out the Ramayana. Vyas Muni, he was also. So all the great masters in this manner, and yet, so this is where, till now I have been only talking about the earthly level. Then we know there are 14 lokas, 7 below and 7 above. There are beings existing there also, they say. So these fellows, if you go to Bhu, Bhuva, Swaha, Tapa, Jana, Maha, Satyam, as you go to the higher lokas, the capacity and the expression of powers till in Satyam, it's maximum. But Bhuva, if you go to Bhuva Lok, it is more than Bhu Lok. Suha, it is even more than the previous two. And this way it keeps increasing. But who is that? Who is beyond all these lokas? That is our Lord, isn't it? So this Lord, in order to correct every now and then, in order to guide us, who are none other than his expressions. Who are none other than his expressions, to guide us that we can reach the same perfection of the rishis, of the yogis, so that we can merge into the Lord and experience the oneness with him while living. He comes into our life, or he comes on this planet every now and then to guide us, to resurrect the Sanatana Dharma, to bring up the Dharma, to reorient our attention, to again remind us that, hey, you are going the wrong way. That's why you are coming to Bhagavad class also every Saturday, isn't it? To remind yourself again and again. That's why you light lamp in your home also every day. So we are doing it, but it has to be even more conscientious approach. What is that approach, and how Rishi Munis have, what is that which they are practicing and we are not practicing? So we know the avatars, isn't it? The 10 avatars are main and 21 are the other one, altogether 21. So we know them. Then even after knowing, how come we are not merging into them and perfecting ourselves? And how come rishis, saints and sages, even living today, have found or discovered that inspiration within them to merge into the divine? So what is missing? That I think will be told in this, and the answer is given by the Lord. So Uddhavji Maharaj asking this question, that what are those particular entities contemplating on which with devotion men of wisdom are able to attain highest perfection. And please, O Lord, I bow to your lotus feet, which are abode of all sanctuaries. So in this manner, having, whenever we want, again we repeat, just like we, half an hour we prepared our mind before we started the discourse. How? Hanuman Chalisa, chanting, mantra, shlokas, sankirtan. Start your day like that. Do you start like that? Or is it only after shower, you just quickly, Om Na Tatra Surya Bhati, train me so yagi bhavu. This is Sanatana Dharma. The moment you get up, Karagre Vasate Lakshmi Karamule Sarasudhi Karamadhetu Govinda Parapate Karadarshanam. The moment you touch the wind, Prithvi Dvai Daya Loka Doroka, and the mantra goes on. Then while showering, Gange Chayvune Chayva Godavri Sarasuti Narmade Sindhumka. So every action that you are performing, you are remembering the divine. Not remembering the divine as if he is separate from you. See, this is the difference. You are remembering the divine, that this, you are chanting the name or remembering him in your mind, but remembering, recognizing that this mental chanting or mouth chanting is happening because of him. That bhav must be there. If that bhav is not there, then you are extending your merging. And you know how to do it. You think of sleep, but your attention is not on the thought of sleep. Where is your attention? On the experience of sleep, isn't it? Exactly the same way. Think of the Lord, chant the name of the Lord, but your attention must be on how? Not just the form, on his infinitude. On his infinitude. Sleep is infinite. Mind is empty. Where does it begin? Where does it end? You don't know. Your attention with feeling, with bhav, has to be on the Lord and his innumerable expressions. You must get overwhelmed, excited, inspired, thrilled that he is present all around you. Lord, make me lock into it. You know, you when you have the in what you call, kaun banega karodpati. So he asked the question, you have to lock in the answer. Ting. So your mind has to get locked into this feeling. And once it's locked in, once locking in means he catches you from inside. He catches you from inside. Once sleep catches you from inside, then nobody can disturb you. When you are trying to sleep and trying to surrender, then any disturbance you can get disturbed, isn't it? Think. So our feeling must be, it must catch me, it must catch me. I want to merge, yes, I am putting my efforts, but he must catch me from it. He must swallow me completely. This feeling has to be there with respect to the divine. With this feeling, you surrender to the Lord, that please explain to me. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha Eva Metadaham Prashtaha Prashnam Prashna Vedambara Yayutsuna Vinashane Sampatnair Arjunena Vai Nyatva Jnati Vadam Garhyam Adharmam Rajahetukam Tato Nivritto Hantaham Hatoyamiti Laukikaha Satada Purusha Vyagro Yuktyame Pratibodhitaha Abhyabhashatama Mevam Yathatvam Ranamudhani Ahamatmodhavami Sham Bhutana Suhrudishwaraha Aham Sarvani Bhutani Tesham Stityut Bhava Pyayaha Aham Gatir Gati Matam Kala Kalavyatam Aham Gunanam Chapyaham Samyam Guninyautpattiko Gunaha Guninam Apyaham Sutram Mahatam Chamahanaham Sukshmanam Apyaham Jivo Durjapanamaham manaha Hiranyagarbho vedanam Mantranam pranava strivruta Aksharanam akarosmi Padanichandasamaham Indroham sarvadevanam Vasunamasmi havyavar Adityanamaham Vishnu Rudranam Nalarohitaha Brahmarshinam Bhruguram Rajarshinamaham Manuhu Devarshinam Naradoham Havirdhanyasmi Dhenushu Siddheshwaranam Kapilaha Suparnoham Patatrinam Prajapatinam Dakshoham Petrunam Hamaryama Mam Vidhyuddhavadaityanam Pralladama Sureshwaram Somam Nakshatraushadinam Anesham Aksharakshasam Airavatam Gajendranam Yadasam Varunam Prabhum Apatam Dhudumatam Suryam Manushyanam Chabhupatim Uchaishavasturanganam Dhatunam Asmikachanam Yamasayamatam Chaham Sarpanam Asmi Vasukihi Nagendranam Anantoham Murugendra Shrungidamshtrinam Ashramanamaham Turyo Varnanam Pratamonaga Tirthanam Srotasam Ganga Samudra Sarasamaham आयुधानां धनुरहं त्रिपुराग्नो धनुष्मतां श्री यस बिकॉज स्पेशल मैनिफेस्टेशंस नो बट इन 10th चैप्टर लॉट मोर वाज गिवन व्हाट आई वाज एक्सप्लेनिंग यू बिफोर दैट वाज गिवन हियर ओनली few examples from all the lokas, I think. Okay, see you. You are not coming next week, no? Okay, you are coming. Next week is last week. Next week is last week. Okay. So they are going to Perth, this couple. So we'll be not seeing them after next week. Okay. Have fun. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha एवमेतदहं पृष्टः प्रश्नं प्रश्नविदाम्बर युयुत्सानां विनशने सपत्नैरर्जुनेन वै He says, in a like manner, I was put there this very question by Arjuna while just going to fight with his enemies at the battlefield of Kurukshetra. O chief of those possessing insight into the meaning of questions. Now see the problem. No, not the problem. Because this question is asked by Uddhav at the end of Krishna avatar. And the Mahabharata war has already happened. So Uddhav was missing in that action, no? He is Mahatma. He has not taken part in the war. He went on a pilgrimage at that time. Who else went to pilgrimage? Balramji went on pilgrimage. Balram was disgusted with war, so he went. But Uddhavji Maharaj, he was a jnani. He didn't want to take part in any, no sides. And so, Vidur also. Three people. So, Bhagwan, just like in everywhere, the answers of great people are never that I am going to tell you. He says similar question was asked. All Upanishads are like that only. All questions in Puranas, questions are asked and the answer is that before also we saw Narad Muniji went to Sage Narayana and Sage Narayana said, oh, this question that you asked, why our mind gets distracted by the world and how to concentrate. Oh, similar question was asked by the rishis to Sanatanand and Sanandan answered this question. Narayan Bhagwan is answering that again through another example. Same way. There he says that I answered a similar question to the great Arjuna and he says in the second verse, Nyatva Gnyativadham Garhyam. Garhyam, adharmam graja hetukam tato nivritto hantaham hatoyam iti laukikaha. He says, feeling like the common man, that I am the slayer and the other one is slain by me, and believing that slaying one's kinsfolk for the sake of kingdom is reproachful and unrighteous, he ceased from that act at the beginning. See? This is our issue. Feeling like a common man. See, this sentence is so simple. Feeling like a common man. So what you should feel like? So should you give an excuse? Oh, we are common people. Many people say, we are grahastha, Swamiji. We are married people. We have responsibilities. You have no responsibility. They say that way. On our face, they say. Sir, kya bolna chahiye? That also I do for some people. That also I do for some people. I'm not joking. There are people here, not here, whose heater I get repaired because they don't have money. they are not able to repay their loan, whatever dakshina is there, I give it to them so that they can make their payments. Someone wants to start business, they don't have money. Serious, just ask her, yesterday I gave. I do that. Nothing, my pocket already remains empty. So answers, feel like a common man. Even if you don't have any, still you can do a lot more. There's always something to give. Remember, life must be only for giving. Life must be only for giving. Your money, whatever dakshina you give, it goes only for good cause, in your name, not in my name. Because this is where it goes. Or when we went to the temple, we did the pujas, I spent the money, not in my name, in all of your name, in every temple. So, stop thinking like a common man. As long as you keep thinking like a common man, you are undermining your potential. You are not allowing yourself to expand. Expansion means when you have nothing, you are still ready to empty whatever you have for the sake of the other. Not foolishly. It's not because I must give, I should keep giving. Even the person who has, you keep giving them. No. You be intuitively find out what is needed by someone. What is their really need? What they really need? For someone, motivation is required. For someone, money is required. For someone, knowledge is required. For someone, just listening is required. For someone, be ready to accept all the download that is required. For someone, argument is required. Because they enjoy that. But you have to be available without judging them. While you are doing all this, the love for them has to remain intact. Your mind must not get corrupted by them, by the circumstance, by the personality. See, this cannot be taught. You have to learn it. You have to catch that knack within yourself. How? And you are not even looking that I want to be of use to other people. You don't want to do. If you think that way, then ego will increase. You have to be, you prepare yourself. You purify yourself. You remember the Lord. And He will use you the way, and opportunities come at every turning of life. Every turn of the road, the opportunity is there for you to share yourself in some manner or the other. See? So, the point here is, see, here when he says, Jnata jnati vayam garhyam adharmam rajya hetukam tato nivrito hantaham hatoyam iti laukik. We kill ourselves by thinking that we are the common man. We kill ourselves, hantoya. We die every time we think we are an individual. We kill ourselves every time we say that I can't do this without even trying. We have already put a lid on the potential. See? Simple sentence. But how much is hidden in that? So Bhagavan says, feeling like the common man, that I am the slayer. So when we do something, where do we go wrong in our thinking? I am the doer, I am the enjoyer. If I am doing it, the good and bad result I will have to face. Good results will take me to heaven, bad results will take me to hell. So I will go to hell, therefore I will not perform this particular action. Why was Arjuna thinking in this manner? Why? Answer? Attachment to his family. Second? Delusion, okay, but more practical. I am the doer. Therefore, I don't want to do the wrong thing and get wrong results. For attachment was one thing. I am the doer. Tell another reason why he is doing these two things.
He thought he was committing
pāpam.
Yes,
that is because he is the doer, so pāpa puṇya automatically is the result. Why these two thoughts are coming in his mind? That he is attached to the family and he is the doer. Why these are happening? Because
he forgot the role also,
but also he's forgotten that the divine is expressing through him at that moment, isn't it? He has studied the scriptures. He has forgotten that this world is cyclical. He has forgotten that nothing in this creation from the Lord's point of view is born or destroyed. When your attention is on that, then will you feel excitement when something is created or loss when something is destroyed? No. Think where your attention should be. While coming, I was asking her, you know, now coronavirus has spread to 64 countries. 64 countries. And I said, you don't get disturbed by it. Immediately, what was her answer? And my statement was, don't get panicked if something. She said, no, I'm not panicked. I'm not anxious. If it happens, it will happen to everyone.
I said, if it happens to everyone, it will happen to me also.
Yeah. But the moment you become, watch in yourself, whenever you are anxious or you are panicking, what happens? Your immune system goes down. That is the time you will become vulnerable. So what is the solution? Samatvam yoga uchyate. Remain calm. What will it affect? Your mind? No. If you are calm, then what will it affect? The body. Where should be your attention? I did not give birth to this body, so why am I getting attached to this body? Let it go. If it happens that, if it comes to that. But prepare in this manner, not only for coronavirus, for life. Think. But Arjuna was different. He was thinking like a common man. Who is only for small things they are excited, for small things they are depressed. Our attention must be on the totality. That's how we grow. And therefore here he says, and believing that slaying one's own people for the sake of kingdom is reproachful and unrighteous, he ceased from that act at the beginning of the war. Sometimes we cease from an act from correcting our own children, from correcting our own wife, from correcting our own husband. Why? No. He will not listen to me. Or, he's my only child. Your infatuation takes over for the child, your attachment takes over to the child, rather than making him into a good person. For the future, you're not thinking long term. You're thinking only short term. You're thinking about your love for the child. You're not thinking about how that child is going to grow if that child is never corrected. If this is true, if you're all nodding, if this is true, have you ever thought you need to correct your thinking? That the thinking that you have is taking you in the wrong direction and I need to correct when it is required. So that it matures. matures as what? Matures into wisdom. For that, continuous correction is required. Not once a week. Once a week is good. But it requires alertness. If you are not correcting your steering wheel on the in the car, you will have many accidents. You won't reach this place. You continuously correct it. Sometimes increase the speed, sometimes decrease the speed, sometimes put the brakes on, sometimes change the lane. It's negotiation so that you reach the destination. Is your mind negotiating through the traffic of thoughts and emotions and convictions to reach the destination of the divine? Or is it succumbing to what every man on this planet is succumbing? Arjuna Sthiti, first chapter of Bhagavad Gita. Think, isn't it? Then, satada purusha vyagro yuktya me pratibodhitaha abhyabhashatamamevam yathatvam ranamurdhani satada purusha vyagro yuktya me pratibodhitaha yuktya me. Here he says in the seventh verse, disillusioned by my reasoning. So when I gave him the Bhagavad Gita, his delusion, he stopped thinking like a common man who's thinking only of survival, who's thinking of not feeling guilty, who's thinking about, common man is thinking about papa punya. Arjuna stopped thinking of papa and punya, because papa and punya is for whom? For the doer. Arjuna stopped becoming the doer. The tiger among men then interrogated me at the van of the fight in the same way as you have done. Whenever we come across Mahatmas in our life, learned people in our life, don't waste their time. Don't waste their time. Ask something which will enrich you. Enrich you. Ask something by which your love for the Lord will increase. Ask something by which your mind will become single-pointed. Ask something by which the doubts which have arisen in your contemplation for towards the Lord, remove those doubts. But we are only asking, my child is not getting scholarship, Swamiji, what should I do? Should I send him to private school or public school? Then I tell, don't send him to school at all. He'll be more intelligent. My parents made mistake of sending me to school. So whenever we are coming across masters, either sit in silence or ask questions, not because you have read them somewhere. Ask questions not because you have been asking the same question to every Mahatma for last 20 years. There are people like that also. Ask question by diving into yourself and then checking what is the missing link. Where are you falling short in merging into the Lord, into the Divine, into the Self? Where are you falling short in becoming single-pointed? Where are you falling short? Why? All these questions which Arjuna has asked or Uddhav has asked, he has not asked because he has prepared a list. These are the questions I'm going to ask. He is there in front of the Lord and he is applying whatever Lord is saying on him. And then these questions are emanating from inside as a result of his contemplation. So he says, So similarly, when he was deluded, he asked the question, what was the, where are we? Huh? As you have done now in the 8th verse, 9th verse, sorry. Wait.
Aham atmo dhavamisham bhutanam suhrudishwaraha aham sarvani bhutani tesham sthityut bhavapyayaha.
So here in the 9th verse he says, I am the self, the befriender and ruler of all these created beings, O Uddhava. In fact, I am all the beings as well as responsible for their birth, life and death. First point. So you must stop worrying about what? At this stage of your life. About survival and death. Born you are already. Isn't it? At the physical. But yes, there are so many activities that are going to be born, so many thoughts that are going to be born, so many emotions that are going to come in the from this moment onwards. They keep bombarding us, isn't it? They keep coming. Don't take responsibility. Instead, our dialogue is, acha, yeah, what is next? Bhagawan ab kya bhejne wala hai? What is he going to send next? Rather than saying, why am I feeling like this? Why am I feeling down? Why am I feeling excited? Why am I feeling overwhelmed? Why am I feeling panicky? Why am I feeling anxious? Why is my heart beating so low? Or a heart is there, it will beat. Sometimes it will beat slow, sometimes fast. But you take responsibility of it. Why it is beating fast? It beats faster. And heart attack. You don't take responsibility. Watch. Oh, yesterday we met someone whose heartbeat went down to 32. And for 2 days they did not realize. If they are saying, why am I feeling so heavy, no energy to do anything. And he's a cut, he always wants to do something. And he was not able to. Then his niece came and she said, oh, my dad also passed away like this. Yeah, I think you should get it checked from the doctor. And immediately he checked the blood pressure, in that the heartbeat comes, the pulse, it was 32. Immediately it was taken to Vanesh. See? Now he's okay. They had to put a pacemaker. But there is another option. If Jnaneshwar Maharaj was thinking, oh my God, my heartbeat is becoming slow, and now it's not there. Oh my God, am I dying? That's one option, no? It's how you are training yourself. Jnaneshwar Maharaj is even alive today after 740 years. 2017, 740 years. Raghavendra Swami is still in Sanjeevani Samadhi in Mantralaya. They are not one or two, there are many like that. That option is there. Either you succumb to fear of death, or you make the death as a doorway to access higher realms, a new potential, a possibility which was not available to you before. This is what happened to Arjuna, no? After listening to Krishna. No, that is false. Because he is speaking bloody Greek. I am Alexander. And how can it be a Siddhar? Saying I am Alexander. He is a white fellow. It's a disease that fellow has. It's not that he has been dug out of a cave. So, I am the self, the befriender of the ruler of all these created beings. So what is Bhagavan saying? I am the self of all beings in all realms, past, present or future. All the lokas. Where is your attention when you are listening to me or I am looking at Where is our attention? Is it on the personality or is it on the essence? Do you feel when you look at your wife or husband that God is talking to you? Or do you feel? I'm not going to complete the sentence. You have already completed in your mind.
Why is he in front of me?
I don't want to say anything. You decide. You have already, if you have decided it wrong, please correct it. And what is the correction? That the Lord is expressing through him. See, then why is he expressing in this manner? Why is he expressing in this manner? Is it to condemn me? If Lord is expressing in this particular manner through that particular body, is it to condemn me? Is it to judge me? Is it to put me down? Is it to make me feel like a doormat? Is it to suck me out of my energy? Is it to use me? Or your attention is, okay, Lord is expressing. What is there for me to learn from here? What is there for me to learn from here? Remember, one couple I told, that communist Keralite, he was married to this woman and she was a Krishna Bhakta, and he said, first day in the house, no God. And she cried for 2 months. And then she said, I can't live like this. I just got married. I'm only crying every day because I'm not allowed to pray to my God. So instead of condemning her husband, what did she do? She started doing Manas Puja of the Krishna. So before it was Krishna Vigraha outside, now it is Krishna Vigraha in her mind, and she's going to do the complete 16-step puja, chanting his name. Was that possible if he had not behaved in this manner? So she did not say that he is a Rakshasa, he is Asura, he is this, he is that. Pati Devo Bhava. She considered, he is my husband. Instead, yes, initially she did cry, but after that, it was a doorway to find an opportunity to find a solution. And she found a solution. Because of that, Krishna became her bosom friend. He will listen to her for everything that she wanted to. She had a personal relationship with him. And so also the husband, after 40 years, realized that his true teacher in life has been his wife. Aye? Pardon me? Whatever. Thought is good to share with everyone, but the way it is implemented is wrong. That's all. And that it becomes a, what you call, kya bolte hain, ek pagalpan ho jata hai, kisi bhi type ka. But what our attention is not on that. Our attention is that she took that opportunity to be more than she was. Are you doing that every moment of your existence, to be more than what the situation demands? With every experience, are you growing into a greater being? Are you expanding? Are you becoming more giving? Are you becoming more accepting? Or are you going the wrong other way? So here Bhagavan says, I am the self of all beings in this creation. That's where our attention must go. This is the instruction he is giving to Uddhava, and through Uddhava he is giving to us, so that we correct our conclusion of life. That I am someone, I am a husband, I am a father, I am a teacher, I am a Swami, this, blah, blah. All these are roles, all these are positions. All these are descriptions of the form or the quality. But what are you essentially? Your ultimate connection is the overriding thought above all this should be the self. The Lord is expressing as the self through me even at this moment. And it should, your love for him must increase on one hand, and the urge that why am I separate from him? Even if I know this now, then why am I separate to him? And therefore, I must do whatever is required to, in this lifetime, realize that he and me are one. So here he says, in fact, I am all the beings as well as responsible for their birth, life and death. So he himself brought you about everything in this creation, all the circumstances, all the people that are coming into your life have come for a reason, even for a short period. If someone is troubling you for your whole life, also for a particular reason. You have not learned the lesson. He will continue in the next life also. He or she. Saad janam ka saad hai. Learn the lesson quickly. The earlier you learn, the more free you are. Then, Sharada Ma, who was the wife of Ramakrishna Paramahams, instead of being the wife, she became the mother of Ramakrishna. He used to address her mother, not as wife. And not many people say, oh mother, in English language also they say, but that's only at a lip level. The feeling is not there. See? So here he says that befriender and the ruler of all these created beings, O Uddhava, in fact, I am all the beings as well as responsible for their birth, life and death. I am the birth, I am the life expressing in every being. When you start recognizing this and accepting this from your heart and are aware of it all the time, will you be tempted to kill the cockroach? Will you be tempted to kill the anything? Your life will automatically become a life of non-violence. Automatic. But as an ego, you try to become non-violent, somewhere mistake is still possible. Continuing, he says, we did that. 10th verse. Aham gatir gatimatam kala kalayatam aham gunanam chapyaham samyam guninya utpattiko gunaha. In the 10th verse he says, I am the motion of the mobile and kala, the time spirit, among those that bring others under their control. Now he starts telling his specific manifestations. Special manifestations. So before he comes to the form, he is coming from the causal, subtle, and then the gross. So what is he saying? I am the motion of the mobile. So you can see something is moving, but what is moving it? Can you see? You are able to breathe, but can you see the breath? You are able to see the car is moving, but can you see the horsepower which is moving it? Energy that is moving it? No. He says, I am that. You can see the waves coming and going, but can you see what is making the waves? What is making the water express as wave? Can you see what is making the planets go around the earth, around the sun? Can you see what is making the earth go around itself every 24 hours? What is that? So here he says that I am the motion of the mobile and kala, the time spirit, among those that bring others under their control. I am the kala himself, I am the time spirit. See? So whatever is coming in your life, good or bad, whatever opportune moments are coming, on unfortunate moments are coming, Then if someone near and dear is passing away because of kaal only, no? Because the time. Time is over. Yoga Sutra says what are the three things? I have repeated it many times. What are the three things that are predetermined? First is? What is the first thing? The species that you will be born into is predetermined. Species, that means the yoni. If you are too attached to the cat, and before the cat dies, if you die, and the last thought is, my darling cat, next life will be meow meow. If that is the last thought. So your yoni, the womb in which the soul will go, is predetermined. Second, what is predetermined? If
parents.
I've said it many times. See, this is, you have to remember. What is the second thing that Patanjali says? The number of breaths that you are going to breathe in that particular yoni. So, the womb is predetermined. How many breaths you are going to take in that life is predetermined. So now you accept that in this life. You know how many breaths you are going to take? Do you know when you are going to die? Any child, sometimes first breath and the next second breath, they are dead. Some live for 1 year or 2 years, isn't it? Some are born, they are born in the womb only. So many stories you hear. It's predetermined. Therefore, sorrow is there only because of attachment. Sorrow is there only because of attachment. If someone has died young, you should be happy. Not sad. At the worldly level, sadness. If you don't express sadness, he's a heartless fellow. But truly, he's free. That was the only thing that soul needed to experience in order to experience freedom. It's free. See? So first was, the yoni is predetermined. Second was, the number of breaths are predetermined. So that's why they say, do pranayam, slow down the breath, so you can live longer. 100 years yoga. And be a problem to everyone around you. साला मरता ही नहीं है कब मेरे को अपनी जायदाद हैंड ओवर करेगा when will he give over make the will hand over the will and property to me he's not dying only third one what is the third one now think if your womb is predetermined number of breaths are predetermined third one is Yes. What experiences are going to come into your life is predetermined. That tarike. So mere koi choice hi nahi hai. No choice. No choice. If you recognize this, you are a wise person. If you don't recognize this, tathastu, suffer. Continue suffering. Continue complaining. But once you accept it, you are as if liberated for that moment. Hey, nothing is my responsibility. Whatever is going to come is going to come. No point remaining, stock market will crash, property prices are going down, I have to think so many days, property pricing up, going up, should I sell, and when you decide to sell, it falls. Same thing, what is going on with you? Remain a witness, whatever is going on. Understand. Kuch to hoga, jiski wajah se ye sab ho raha hai. And it happens in everyone's life in a different manner. So again we repeat, remember these things. It will reform you. First is the yoni, the womb in which you are going to be born is predetermined. Don't forget the word predetermined. Predetermined. That means it's not your choice. How many breaths you are going to take in this lifetime is predetermined. You have got no idea. All you can do is slow down the breath. So instead of 15 breaths a minute, reduce it to 5, 7, 10. Your life will increase a bit longer.
That is determined anyway.
What?
The number of breaths.
Yeah, but if suppose there is every day you are breathing, say 70,000 breaths. Suppose 100,000 breaths every day. And in your quota, 2 crore breaths are written. So, if you do regular pranayama and slow down,
couple of years,
3 years, 4 years. Jnaneshwar Maharaj has stopped, and therefore, death is not able to touch him. Raghavendra Swami has stopped the breath and gone into hibernation. So-called. Therefore, the death is not able to catch him. Think. And the third was the experiences that are going to come. Why this is happening to me? I don't know. I never did any bad to anyone. Predetermined. Why this is happening? You know, see, many houses we go, the children are born paraplegic or disabled, whatever. It's just words. Why me? If you go into why me, gone, you will be depressed. If you accept that this is how it was and now this is the situation, what can I do? How do I deal with this? Without feeling guilty, without taking responsibility that I am the creator, I must have done something wrong because this child is born in this manner. No, it is not your fault. The soul decided to experience that type of body. Doctors may not accept that, but this is how our scriptures, because in the end, our mind has to remain calm and at peace. And if you accept that, then you take care of that child to the best of your ability within the means that you have. Don't feel guilty. Because what you created was what the body child is created. What is he saying here in this particular sentence? I am the one who creates birth, who creates life, and who brings about death. He alone is the three. So he alone is expressing. When we are divorced from this conclusion that he alone is expressing as birth, life, and death, then we take responsibility. Isn't it? In everything in our life. And then, when we take responsibility, there are repercussions. Sometimes you will be on a high, sometimes you will be low. Don't take responsibility. Don't take responsibility. Don't take responsibility does not mean not doing what is required to be done. That must be done. But inside you understand it's the play of the divine. This knack you have to develop in yourself. So here he says, I am the motion of the mobile, the kal, the time spirit among those that bring others under their control. I am the state of equilibrium in the shape of prakriti of the three gunas. I am the state of equilibrium. This is specific. Specific. So where can you access him? If you focus on, we are talking about what will benefit you. What was the first? He is the motion. What is the second? He is the kal. That means You should not think about death because it will come whenever. So he is the giver of death. Third, he is the equilibrium of the Triguna Prakriti. So if you, what does it mean? Balance your attention must be on balancing the sattva rajas tamas within you. So when we say samatvam yoga uchyate, meaning the oscillation of sattva rajas tamas has to be halted. And how can you halt it? How can you halt it? You cannot. You cannot. Only Lord can. So, okay, I understand Lord can. Then what can you do then? Because you are so used to doing, what do you do? You remember him at the mind level, at the breath level, calm it down, at the physical level, at the deed level. Don't do anything in hurry-burry. Everything should be as an expression of the divine through you. Do everything with awareness, without losing your cool, without losing the poise. Remain centered. Don't get too excited, don't get too lazy, don't get too knowledgeable in the sense, don't show off your knowledge. And in this way, initially we start that way, and eventually the complete integration of sattva rajas tamas is ida pingla sushumna at a kundalini level. Ida is the chandra nadi. No, ida is the ping chandra nadi or the surya nadi. Ida is the surya nadi. Pingla is the chandra nadi. This is the intellect, is the surya nadi. Emotion is the chandra nadi. See, chandra nadi is the action, surya nadi is the desire, fire. When these two get come close to each other and start synchronizing, a third nadi is invoked, and that is the Sushumna Nadi, and Sushumna Nadi is the Saraswati. So here it is Durga. Durga is the Pingala, Lakshmi is the Ida, and Saraswati is the Sushumna. And you go look for it, it's nowhere. But if you start integrating, you can invoke them. But to go beyond these three, they have to merge into the Saraswati must merge into the Lord. And where is Lord found? In an agitated mind? Can you remember Lord in an agitated mind or in a calm mind? In a single pointed mind? In a purified mind, isn't it? So here he says, he's talking about his manifestation at the totality level, at the Ishwara level. He says, when these three are in equilibrium, I am the equilibrium. See how beautiful? Because by nature, the Shakti, Ichha Shakti, Kriya Shakti, Jnana Shakti, or Ida Pingla and Sushumna, or Durga Lakshmi Saraswati, by nature they are chanchal, isn't it? They are oscillate. Their nature is to oscillate or not to oscillate. Is equilibrium, this is one way I explain to you that you synchronize them and you are in equilibrium. But is equilibrium disturbed by, or is witnessing disturbed by the movement of the three or non-movement by the three? So first you synchronize and you catch, be the equilibrium. Once you have established in the witnessing or the equilibrium, then whether these three energies become active or non-active, it does not matter.
That means when you
equipoise or equilibrium doesn't matter.
Samadhi.
It it samadhi, but it does. What I'm talking about is the natural state, sahaja. Then it does not matter whether mind is active or not active. So he says, I am that equilibrium which never is disturbed. So then next one is what? Of the three gunas of Vedi, and the property, where are we? And the property natural to a thing with attributes. So every property of every object or thing in this creation. What is the property of space?
Sound.
What is the property of air?
Touch.
Okay, those who know, don't tell. I won't ask others. Touch, but that is incomplete answer. What is the property of air? Its own property is touch. But is it only touch? Or sound is also expressing through air, isn't it? So it's borrowing the sound from space. What is the, what is fire's own property?
Form
and light. Form and light. And what is it borrowing from air? Touch. And what is it borrowing from the space?
Sound.
What is the proper water's own property?
Taste.
Plus the three.
And the three from above, it has got form also. Then what is the property of earth? Its own property.
Smell.
And it is borrowing the four from? What is your property? Can you see? Can you hear? Can you touch? Can you smell? So all five are included. So you are a mixture of these five. What is the property of this brick? What is the property of this brick?
Earth
means all five are present. But can you see space? No, no. But all five properties are there. So every object in this creation will have its own specific property. What is the specific property of brick, even though all these five are there?
Yeah.
It has a particular form, it is hard, isn't it? It has some utility value. Oh, but this body is also form and that is form. So can you this body be put in the instead of the brick? Can it be? Start making the wall of human beings. Huh? What is that?
One king did that.
Aurangzeb also did it. Chunwa dete the Guru Gobind Singh ke bachon ko chunwa diya tha andar, diwar ke andar, zinda. See? So each thing has its own property. That property which is for what that particular thing is recognized for, that property or quality I am. So in you, if love is expressing, non-violence is expressing, Satyavrata is expressing, Sankalpa Shakti is expressing, Dhairya is expressing, anger is expressing, he's an angry young man. Angry young lord. So all qualities are his. Now don't think God is only positive. Kama, krodha, lobha, moha, madha, matsya are also his expressions only. But through the tamas, through the disturbance, through the agitation. Then continuing, 11th verse, how much time? Okay. Last verse.
Guninamapyaham sutram mahatam cha mahanaham sukshmanamapyaham jivo durjayanamaham manaha.
In the 11th verse he says, I am the sutra, the active aspect of the mahatattva. See now what he's doing, from the before the manifestation of creation, he's trying to give you the points where you can catch him. He is the time, he is the equilibrium. Then after equilibrium, what happens? the equilibrium gets lost. So then what happens? Sattva Rajastamas. When Sattva Rajastamas happens, what is the first thing that comes about? Mahatattva. Mahatattva is what? That which is expressing through Hiranyagarbha is Mahatattva. Mahatattva is the life and Hiranyagarbha is the form at the totality level. But it has not manifested yet. It is still in its unmanifest form. Hiranyagarbha and Mahatattva. So here he is saying, I am the Sutra. Where is it? Where are we? Tenth. I am the Sutra, the active aspect of Mahatva. So there are three words by which you can recognize, four words. In Bhagavad Gita, the word for Mahatattva is used as Sutra also, is used as Pranava also. No, sorry, Prana also, not Pranava, Prana. See? And sometimes they loosely use the word Mahatattva and Hiranyagarbha. So Hiranyagarbha, Garbha means the womb, Hiranya means the golden womb. In that, the life which is expressing, that is called Mahatattva. The Mahat, the greater than the greatest, Tattva, the essence. Which essence? The manifest essence, which is other, not other than Ishvara. It's not other. Ishvara himself is expressing through that golden womb, and when he expresses through that golden womb, he is called as Mahatattva. When the husband, when the man expresses through the idea of woman, wife, then he is called as husband. When he expresses through the idea of his mind, means is overpowered by the idea called daughter or son, then the one who is expressing through that idea is father. Exactly like that. This is how the creation from the infinite is coming down, and he is giving you the pointers where you can. So you will see now by the end of this that there is no place that he is not. So here, just quickly, I am the Sutra, the active aspect of the Mahatattva. The very first evolute principle of cosmic intelligence among big things. So who is Brahmaji? Brahmaji is the cosmic intelligence. For it is from here that all the sutras come. Even if the invaders destroy all the scriptures, our Rishi, Muni, which is lurking in every one of you, at the right time, we can just chant Om, click into that Hiranyagarbha or Akash, total space, and download cloud computing. cloud we saved. It's slowly coming to that only. And you can download. So, to be afraid that scriptures are going to be lost, leave it to RSS. Leave it to VHP. Your attention must not go there. Your attention should be, I am complete. I am of the nature of the divine. When Raman Maharishi was asked why you are not taking part in the freedom struggle, he says, of course I am taking part in the freedom struggle. No, but we don't see you doing any Andolan or fasting or boycott movement like Mahatma Gandhi. He says, I am also, I am doing all that. He is thinking of the freedom of the country, and I am doing it for the freedom of the self. I boycott food, I boycott this, I go on fast for what? For purifying my mind. So I am also in the freedom struggle, but freedom from I. His attention is on freedom of the country. This is the difference. So choice is yours. Where you want to be. You want to die a martyr? Welcome. So here he says, that I am the cosmic intelligence among big things. So he is the Brahma. Mahatattva is the Brahmaji. Brahmaji among the big things. Big things means at the totality level. And then he says, of subtle principles, I am the Jiva, the embodied soul. And of those that are difficult to conquer, I am the mind. Now, three things he has said. He is the same. The total life expressing is Brahmaji. If there is total, there has to be individual. The individual life expressing is the soul or the Jiva. And Jiva has something else, another faculty, because he is able to see that, say that I am a Jiva, or is able to establish his identity as a Jiva, and that is the mind. Total also he is, individual also he is, and the mind also he is. Now start thinking. Which one are you? What are you? You have to redefine yourself. You have to accept yourself not like a common man. Devotee has got only one relationship, that is with the Lord. Isn't it? So contemplate on these points till here. That first one was, he is the time principle. Second was, he is the equilibrium of the four. No, he is the Kala, he is the time himself, he is the Prana, and he is the time. And then he is the equilibrium of the three gunas. Then, when those gunas express, he is that equilibrium now is expressing as the Brahmaji at the totality level, Jiva as the individuality level, and the Jiva's faculty through which he perceives the world. Is that is the mind. So Brahmaji, Jiva, the soul, and the mind are all actually one. Have you ever seen when you go to the ocean that there is a big heave in the ocean? The total heave. It goes down and then comes up. In that one heave, how many waves are there? Many waves are there, isn't it? Within that heave, there can be many smaller heaves. And in those smaller heaves, there is many waves which are coming and going. Like another way of looking at it. Look at this light, it is falling on the... this light which I have here, this is falling on my book. Is this the only light that is falling on the book? I'm asking. Then which other light? This light also is falling. That light is also there. But can you see it? You can only see this light following, isn't it? But what are all these lights? The same electricity. Right? Exactly the same way. The same one is expressing as the total life, the individual life, and the mind. So in other words, he is expressing as the Brahmaji, as the Jiva, and as the Chidabhas, the mind. Chidabhas, the reflected consciousness. Reflected consciousness is not possible without the
mind.
Without the mind. So that mind also he is. Now start thinking of, you may not understand. Just keep this idea in front of your mind for the next 1 week. Let him reveal the unity.
Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om.